Turkestan. East Turkestan, now called Xinjiang, is under Chinese occupation. In 2004, the East Turkestan government in exile was established in Washington, D.C. Anwar Yusuf Turani, an ethnic Uyghur, a political activist and an educator, was the leader and driving force behind this movement. In 1995, he established the East Turkestan National Freedom Center, which is a human rights organization. East Turkestan, Xinjiang, was never Chinese territory. China wants the world to believe that this is the case by developing and inculcating this myth. By the way, the Chinese are not an ethnic group that lived in this territory, very similar to Zionism's false claims to historic Palestine. By peddling this falsity, the Chinese want to lay claim to all of Central Asia as being Chinese territory. Before the communist occupation of East Turkestan in 1949, the Chinese made up 2% of the population of East Turkestan. This figure included the invading army, the police, and the colonial government officials. There were no Chinese farmers or livestock herdsmen in the territory. The Chinese government now portrays all supporters of East Turkestan independence movement as terrorists and extremists. President of the East Turkestan government in exile, Ghulam Usman, has been cautioning underdeveloped countries against Chinese aid, citing that when the aid gets too difficult for the debtor country to repay, China will claim their land. Using Singapore as an example, President Usman points out that Singapore has a majority Chinese population, thanks to the mass influx of Chinese immigrants. China has taken over Singapore without using any military force. Chinese authorities have incarcerated over 3 million Uyghurs, Kazakhs, Kyrgyz, Uzbeks, and Tatars in this region. It is about time that the world relates to East Turkestan's movement for an independent state and comes forward to help it.